Folks, this is Deep Indian Prepper coming to you with an intention of showing you the minimum first aid kit. According to me, we should be kept at every home, especially in India. Most of the products here have been purchased or acquired by me, and I do not solicit any company or firm showing the materials. So here we go. See, I got this box from Amazon. It's from a company called Milton. I think you can see the logo, Milton, and it's cost me around, let's say, the price varies from time to time. It costs me around 170 to 200 bucks. See, the best thing is very sturdy. This handle is very sturdy. Even if you can you can invert it, but it doesn't fall off anything. Everything stays in the place. And there is also semi protective child lock. You cannot just open it like this. You have to put it up, then pull it down, then the case opens. Now, the best thing about this is it has been compartmentalized, and we have two compartments, smaller one at the top and the bigger compartment at the bottom. So part by part we will explain this. Let's say the first things which we keep here is one normal digital thermometer for everyday fever and temperature checking. The next is which can be found in almost every Indian household. That's a cream, a tube of Neosporin. It's a time tested antiseptic cream, and when any cut or something happens, we just for skin and eyes, any infection of the skin and eyes, not any infection, you should take a permission of your doctor first. But we usually use it for any cuts, like in kitchen and while playing, if you fall down, we just clean the wound properly with soap water, then we apply this. This is Neosporin. Okay, the next comes, these two are in the first compartment, the digital thermometer, and I cannot show you any brands as such because I do not solicit it. And the next emergency thing to keep in the topmost rack is a couple of band-aids. I have both varieties, that is washproof, which are these, Hansaplast washproof, and the normal band-aids. If you are working in a let's say a watery environment like kitchen or something, so you have to get a washproof. That way no water contamination, any wound which is free of external water contact will heal very fast. So I have kept a bunch of these here. And the next will be some common medicines around the house. Obviously away from the hands of children or away from you, even if you have any allergies as such. So the first medicines, I am keeping some rabeprazole tablets with domperidone. That's mainly used in empty stomach, and the rabeprazole with domperidone, that's mainly used in the empty stomach. I don't know if I can focus it or not properly. Let's see. Yeah. For any mild to moderate nauseas, normal nauseas, indigestions, you can take it in the empty stomach and you may get good relief. And another thing is which I keep is a normal painkiller with hyphenate default for small swellings and pain. We can keep even in mild fever also, we can use. And then I keep this is called WinSTH. Again, I don't claim any brand endorsement. This has been kept for this is with muscle relaxant. Often we get some this is with muscle relaxant. Often we get some sprain, strains and everything. So I keep this as a backup emergency reserve unless and until I can go to the doctor if the problem persists. And I won't advise anyone to self-medicate themselves. You may be allergic to something, so better ask the permission of your general physician or doctor who before assembling this. I have taken the permission, so I am assembling this. And the next common four tablets of paracetamol. This even I carry when I go out. I will show you in the next videos that I have put together an EDC bag, that is everyday carry bag, which will always be with me when I travel or go outside. So these are plain paracetamol 500s. Plain paracetamol 500, I don't know. Plain paracetamol 500 tablets. If you can see. Yeah. Paracetamol 500 tablets. Okay. This can be used in mild pain and fever as well. So this will go into my small medicine compartment. I will organize them afterwards. The next thing which comes to us, it's a spray. It's almost an anesthetic spray. Not you can see in low back pain, joint pain, sprains and strains and muscular pain. We use this in all these things while working or suddenly lifting any heavy equipment or whatever. We can get a low back pain, joint pains. Yeah. So this gives a good relief. So it's always there. Even while I travel, I keep a pack of this here. And the next thing which I will keep in my, actually two things I keep. You can keep only one. These are for toothaches. I will show you. This is for gingivitis, that is gums, bleeding gums, gum problems, after tooth removal if you have any pain, if your artificial teeth or dentures give you any irritation, the teeth are very sensitive and all. In throat infection also, you can put some in hot water and salt water, rinse, toothaches, painful gums. These are always with me. Although I have a very good oral hygiene, still you never know. The same thing is with this, Zytel. It has lignocaine as well, so instant relief from pain is achieved, usually achieved, unless there is a very severe infection. So I always keep this because I've seen people having nightmares from pain. And the next thing which I will show you is a small coagulant, that is blood stoppage drops. In case of small minor cuts, you can use this. Even I use this soaked in cotton to place if I have any nose bleeding also. And this usually stops bleeding. You have to put there and hold the cotton. Say if I cut in my finger, I have to drop some of these in the cotton, hold it for around, let's say, 5 to 10 minutes, let's say. If you remove it, the bleeding will stop. So, and even with nose bleeding, you can pack the nose with the cotton dipped in this solution. But all of these are subject to the approval of your personal doctor. Next is for, I use this, this is called dressing. The main component which I like in this is povidone iodine. This is a very good germicidal. After you clean the wound, you can put this, and I don't know, you can see or not, this is a patented product. It has some antibiotics effective against bacteria including spores, fungi, yeast, protozoan, viruses, even the presence of blood, serum, pus and necrotic tissues. See, in case of burst, boils or something like that, you can use this. Even I use this in cuts also, direct apply to the cuts, unless you are allergic to any component of this. So I always keep this in my place. Any cuts and wounds, just clean it, put it in there. So it helps me to take care of the wound. The next things I will show you, I will take an overview. This is a small sticoplast or leukoplast, whatever you call it. Just you can tie off the edges of a bandage with this. Everybody knows it has multiple uses other than this also. Always, you can see I have used a bit. Always handy to have something like this in hand. And I keep some sterile packed gauzes as well. And a few pair of gloves, sterile nitrile gloves, sealed. Again some gauzes, but of a different consistency than the others. These I have used some, so it's not sealed. So I will have to replace this. You have always to seal it up. Once you touch it with your bare hands, it's gone. I got this from one of my friends who is a doctor. And one more thing which I always keep is an ORS salts. These are very, very handy salts. I mean, in case you are dehydrated or let's say you're having a diarrhea, dysentery, some like symptoms, you can always these to refresh your body, to rehydrate yourself. There are various companies in India which manufacture this. Even government supplies are also there, and every one of them is as good as the others. Use with caution in impaired renal function or intestinal obstruction. You have to always take a permission of your doctor before using all this, and then you can build up your store according to your allergies or whatever. And these are what I called very, very tough gloves. In case I cannot open it because it's a sealed one, it's purely sealed, gamma treated surgical gloves. I keep a pair of them. I got this from a friend. It lasts better than these surgical pair of gloves lasts better than this. So again, we will sum up. We have 2 pair of surgical gloves which we are putting back inside, 1 sachet of ORS or oral rehydration salts which we are putting back in this, and 1 tube of wound dressing material which we are again putting back into this, 1 sticoplast or leukoplast, 1 sprain relief spray. I'll just take it off. Sorry, I have to, my tripod just broken down. It's still sealed. I've not used this one. I'll just remove the covering. 1 small blood stopping material. I will keep this inside because it's almost expired its due date. Just remember, once you open this, you have to use within 1 month, not more than that. I think that's what in the level. However, please do confirm before buying it out. I am keeping 2 pairs of emergency tooth relief pain materials, and ulcers also you can use. Sore throat, denture irritation. Suppose you put some, if you are a non-vegetarian, if you prick your gums with, let's say, fish, bones, whatever. or a toothpick injury, you can use this. So it will give you temporary relief till you can visit your nearest dentist. So this way. And sterile vacuum, what's called sterile sealed gauze. Now you have the paracetamol, the painkillers, and the muscle relaxant all put together here. The band-aids, washproof and otherwise, all put together here. The neosporin cream for eyes and wounds also put together here, and a piece of thermometer. I am just expanding slowly, just researching and expanding slowly, so I don't have much. I don't have much need other than these. So if I let come to know that I can add some more things, I will definitely add and update this video. Okay, thank you. That will be all. Do subscribe and leave your comments in the comment section. Any criticisms, positive or otherwise, will be sincerely welcomed. Just subscribe and press the bell icon. Thank you.